Hello everybody, my name is Molemi. I am 11 years old in grade 6 and I am Nal'ibali's Reading Ambassador. So today I will be reading to you from Nal'ibali's Read-Aloud Story Collection 3. So in this story collection there is 5 stories and I will be reviewing one of the stories and I will be reading the other. The story I will be reviewing is Wait Until I'm Fat Enough. And the story that I will be reading to you is The Pouch of Gold. Okay, so let's start with The Pouch of Gold. One morning, a homeless man woke up. He had spent the previous night begging for food. But no one had shown him any kindness. His stomach was growling because he was very hungry, desperate to find food. He walked through the village market, begging merchants for their leftovers. "Please, please, it's been 2 days since I've eaten. Please give me your leftovers to a poor homeless man," he pleaded. But most people pretended he was invisible. Those who saw him threw rotten fruit at him and called him names like street rat and slum dog. After many tries and many insults, the man decided to go scratching through a nearby rubbish dump, hoping he might find food there. While he was searching through piles of old rubbish, he suddenly saw a small leather pouch that was tied at the top with a string. He picked it up and opened it. It was full of gold coins. With a heart filled with joy, he counted his treasure. 1, 2, 3, 100 gold coins, he said when he had finished counting. This will feed me for the rest of my life. As the man ran back into the market, looking forward to having a full stomach, he heard a merchant shouting, "Listen, everyone, I have lost my gold pouch. I have lost my pouch full of gold coins. I will reward anyone who brings it to me." The homeless man had a kind heart and he felt bad for the merchant. He decided to do the right thing. "Is this the pouch he lost?" he asked, holding up the pouch he had found. "Oh my, you found it," said the merchant, taking the pouch and counting the gold coins inside. The homeless man waited a while, then he asked softly, "Sir, you said something about a reward." "Reward?" scoffed the merchant. "Why should I give you a reward? You have stolen some of the coins." "I have not taken anything from the pouch. Please, can I have the reward that you promise?" asked the homeless man. "The pouch I lost had 200 gold coins in it. Now it only has 100 coins. You have already stolen more than your reward," said the merchant angrily. "Please, sir, I have not stolen anything," explained the homeless man. "All the coins are in the pouch exactly as I found them." "Go away before I call the king's guard to arrest you," shouted the merchant. "I may not seem like much to you, but I am an honest man," said the homeless man. "Call the guards and I will prove myself before the king." So the merchant called the guards and the merchant followed them and the homeless man to the king. "What can I do to help the two of you?" asked the king when the merchant and the homeless man were standing in front of him. The merchant was the first to speak. He told the king his side of the story and explained how many gold coins had been in the lost pouch and how the homeless man had stolen half of them. The king listened to the merchant, then he turned to the homeless man and asked, "What do you have to say for yourself?" "My king, I found the gold pouch in the rubbish bin, and it had only 100 gold coins in it," said the homeless man, bowing his head as he spoke. "This is the truth." The king thought for a while, and then he said, "Merchant, am I correct? You said that your pouch had 200 gold coins." "Yes, my king," said the merchant. "I see," said the king, stroking his long beard. "Well, I believe both of you and I can solve this easily. Merchant, you said that the pouch you lost had 200 gold coins in it. This is a lot of gold to carry in a small pouch, but the pouch this homeless man found in 100 had only 100 gold coins in it. That means that this is not your pouch that you lost. I order you to give it to the homeless man immediately." And so the merchant had no choice but to give the pouch to the homeless man. The homeless man's honesty had paid off, and he had lived a long and happy life with plenty to eat every day. The end. So that was the gold pouch story. And just a reminder, this is Nal'ibali's Read Aloud Story Collection 3. There are 4 of them available. You can get them at all CNA stores. So here's 1, 2, 3 that I'm reading now, and 4. Now let's get to the book, to the story review. The story I'm going to review, as I said, is Wait Until I'm Fat Enough. So now this story is about a goat who wants to go to the mountains during summer to eat the good leaves that are there. But at first she encounters a leopard who wants to eat her. But she asks the leopard to wait until when the summer's finished, when she'll be big and fat. So then at the end of the summer, when she comes down from the mountain, halfway before she gets down fully, she remembers that she's going to be eaten as soon as she gets down and gets worried. But then a hare comes and tells her that she doesn't need to worry. He will help her get down and not be eaten. So he puts on some of his best clothes and puts a saddle on the goat. He rides the goat down to the bottom of the hill where the leopard is laying waiting for the goat. So now the goat asked who the hare is. The hare says he was sent by the king to fetch 10 lion skins for his new wife. And he said that that leopard would be a perfect skin. So now by the time the leopard hears this, he gets scared and runs away immediately, therefore leaving the goat not to be eaten. So thanks to the hare being able to know what would scare the leopard, the goat would not be eaten. So I give this story a 3.5 stars. I really like the illustration though. It's got like really liney artwork. We've got some bit more it's got quite some jaggedy shapes. Let me show you. So here is the first illustration. I hope you can see that. This is the first illustration when she's first going up the hill. This is when she's up the hill eating the leaves that she wanted to eat. Then this is when they came down to see the leopard. Oh, And actually, at the end of each of these stories, there's a little get creative section. For this one, it said, invite your child to suggest what the leopard was thinking as the hare was explaining his special mission. Then ask them to draw a picture of this scene and include a thought bubble. So now, and for the pouch of gold, the get creative section for that one is, imagine what the merchant wanted to put, imagine that the merchant wanted to put a reward notice in the local newspaper. What would it look like? What would it say? Invite your children to design the notice. That's it. Thank you for watching, and remember that you can go buy these story collections at Nal'ibali. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!